In this video, I'm going to show you how you can get more out of FaceTime on your iPhone. We'll cover how to edit your profile, start new calls, create links to invite anyone, including people who do not have an Apple device, and use features like screen sharing, live captions, and taking FaceTime photos while you're on a call. I'll also show you how to view and delete your call history. Let's take a look at FaceTime on the iPhone. Let's go over to my iPhone. Now, the first thing we're going to look at is how you create a profile. The profile is what people see when you make a call. So I like to think of this as the first step. So what we do to create our profile is we open up the FaceTime app. It is just an app on your iPhone. So I tap on it. And now what we need to do is we need to go to Edit in the upper left-hand corner. When I tap on Edit, you're going to see your name up here. In my case, here's my name. When I tap on that name, what I'm able to do is edit my profile. So from here, I can go and edit the photo. If I want to share my name and photo when I make a call, I make sure that that slider is on. And then I can also select my name. So I can go and change the name that shows when I make a phone call. And then we can also set how we want to share our information. I have mine set to contacts. It's automatically going to share my information, my name, my photo with anyone that is in my contacts. We do have another option. If you don't want to do that, you can set it to always ask. So it's not going to share that information. It'll ask you if you want to share that information. So if you want to be a little bit more private, you might want to put that on always ask. So that's our profile. When you've made all of your changes, all you do is just tap on Done in the upper right-hand corner, and it saves the changes. So that's how we create our profile. Now that we know how to create the profile, how do we make a FaceTime call? Well, basically, we have two different ways to do this. We can create a link. We're going to come back to this one in a little bit. Or what we can do is we can create a new FaceTime call. We're first going to focus on FaceTime call. With FaceTime here, what you're doing is you're making a call to someone with an Apple device, such as an iPhone, an iPad, or a Mac. If you want to make a call with someone that does not have an Apple device, then what you need to do is you need to create a link, send them that link, and then they can join that call from their browser. Again, we'll come back to this one. Let's first just take a look at basic FaceTime calls. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to tap on New FaceTime. Tap on it. Now what we need to do is we need to invite who we want to create a FaceTime call with. So from here, I can go to Suggested. I can also tap on the plus here. And when I tap on the plus, I can select who I want to create a FaceTime call with. Or what I can do is I can just start typing in here. So let's just say I wanted to create a FaceTime call with my personal phone here. I tap on it. We can see it added the name up here. We can have up to 36 people in a FaceTime call. To start adding another person, I can just start typing another name in here, and it'll add that name. I can tap on the plus there. And then once I have all my names in this area here, I can make my FaceTime call. And again, we can have up to 36 people on a FaceTime call with iOS 18. So we're just going to keep this simple, and we're just going to call one person. We're going to call my personal phone here. So now that I know who I'm going to call, how do I make a call? Well, basically, we have two different options. It all depends on if you want to make an audio call or a video call. If you just want to make an audio call like an old telephone, then what you do is you tap on the telephone here. When I tap on that, it's going to make an audio call. It will not turn on the camera. If you want to make a FaceTime call with video, then what you do is you tap on FaceTime. And when you do that, what it's going to do is it's going to call the person that you have up here. They'll have to answer it, just like any other phone call. And once they answer it, you'll be able to either hear them or hear them and see them. So that's how we can easily make a call. Let's go ahead and make a call. We're going to first start out with an audio call here. I tap on it. And now what it's doing is it's calling my other phone. So what I'm just going to do is I'm just going to answer it here. I'm not going to pull up the phone, but basically my other phone has answered it here. So now What are my different options here? Well, basically what I'm able to do is select the audio. Where do I want to hear this other person? Right now it's through the earpiece up here towards the top. But if I wanted to put it on speakerphone, I just tap on this, and then from here, I can select speaker, or I have a HomePod, I could also put it on my HomePod. So that's how we can select where we're going to hear that other person. If I want to transfer this over to a video call, maybe I do want to make this a FaceTime call. All I have to do is just tap on FaceTime here, and it'll turn this into a FaceTime call. If I want to mute the call, I could do that as well. Tap on this, and then what it's going to do is it's going to mute the microphone, so they're not going to be able to hear me. So if I need to talk over something with my wife and I don't want them to hear me, I just tap on that. You're going to see it turns red here, and now this microphone is muted. They cannot hear what I'm saying. To unmute it, you just tap on it again, and it is unmuted. Now remember how we can add more people. Maybe I do want to add more people to this call. To do that, you just tap on the little symbol here, add, and now I can go and add more people. And then their phone will ring. Once they answer it, they'll be on this call. Again, up to 36 people. And then if we want to end the call, just like hanging up with them, we just tap on end. And then our last option, new in iOS 18, is share. When I tap on share here, what I'm able to do, let's go ahead and tap on it. What I'm able to do is share my screen, so I could share my screen with the other person. I could show them how to do something as an example. Or what I could do is I could ask to share their screen, so I'd be able to see what they're doing on their iPhone. So this is a great way of working with someone if they're having a problem. Now, the reason why mine is grayed out is just because of my screen sharing software. I'm sharing the screen so I can record this, so it's just grayed out. But you would be able to tap on either one of those. Once you tap on those, the other person will get the invitation, and then they can share their screen with you, or they'll be able to see your screen on their phone. Pretty simple to do. Again, when you're all done, all you have to do is just tap on end, and it'll end that call. So that's how we make an audio call. Now let's take a look at how we make a FaceTime call with the video. Works pretty similar, but you're going to see that the interface is going to change a little bit. So what I'm going to do is go over here to New FaceTime. And now I'm going to add myself, and I'm going to go to FaceTime because I want to include video. I tap on New FaceTime here, and it's going to make a FaceTime call with video. So I tap on it. I'm going to go to my other phone, and I'm going to answer it. And I have to turn off my microphone there. You get a little bit of feedback in there. All right, so you can see that the interface has changed here a little bit. That's because I have video here. So I'm able to see myself here. This is from my camera, so as I move my camera around that I'm holding, I can see my face, so I can see what they are seeing. And then in this area here is my personal phone, which is sitting on my desk, so it's looking up at the ceiling fan there. But basically, this is a video call. All right, so now, where are the controls? Well, you're going to see that the controls disappeared. This is to optimize the video. So how do we get the controls back? Well, all we have to do is just tap on it. So I'm going to tap anywhere on the display, and we get our controls back. Again, they will disappear again if I don't do anything. Let's take a look at these controls. If we go, I'm going to tap on it so it doesn't go away here. If we go to the very top here where you can see the eye, it's a little bit grayed out. When I tap on the eye, this allows me to add more people. So this is how I can go and add more people with a FaceTime call. Again, up to 36 people. I can also share this link. Again, we'll talk about that in a little bit. But if you share this link with someone that's not on an iPhone, if they open it up in Google Chrome or Edge, they'll be able to actually join this FaceTime call with their computer. You don't need to have an iPhone, but it works through a link. And then we have live captions. If I were to turn this on, the iPhone would actually make live captions. We'd be able to read what is being said. It's just live captions, like subtitles. And then our last option here is silence join requests. When this is turned on and someone wants to join the meeting via a link, this will silence you. You're not going to be able to hear that they want to come in. So typically what I would do is I would recommend leaving that off. So then you can hear when people want to join, when it's a link. So that's how we can add people there. Now I'm going to tap on done here. And we're back at my screen. Let's go ahead and tap on the screen. Over on the left, I have my audio. So where do I want to hear the audio? Well, I can set it for the speaker, or what I could do is I could set it for AirPods if I had AirPods in here. I can also set if I want to use the camera. This is not going to turn it into an audio call. It's just going to turn off the camera. So let's go ahead and tap on it. And now we can see when we look at the bottom here, that is what the other person is seeing. They're seeing my profile pic. They are not seeing my camera. So we can easily turn on and off the camera just by going up to the top here. So let's just go ahead and turn it back on. And now we're looking at me again. Mute it. This just mutes the microphone. We also have our sharing options, just like we did before. So if I wanted to share my screen, or if I wanted to ask the other person to share their screen, I could do that. Again, it's just grayed out because of my screen recording software. But basically, you just tap on which one you want there. Pretty simple to do. And then, if I want to end the call, I tap on the X. Now, before we end the call, what you may want to do is switch to the back camera. Right now, it's using the front camera. I'm looking at my iPhone here. Well, what I would like to do is I would like to show them something from the back camera over here. Well, what you do then is you just tap to get the controls, and you're going to see that there's this little control here. And what this is going to do is switch the camera. You're going to see my messy desk there. Tap on it again, and it brings it back. Where we can also add effects. You're going to see that we have this little star here. I tap on that, and you can have a little bit of fun with this. What you're able to do is add different effects to the FaceTime call. So if this is a little bit of a boring conversation, you could just go and put Z up there. And then to get rid of these, you just tap on them again. And when you do, you're going to see a little X. So I'm going to tap on Z. We have this little X over here. I tap on that, and it'll get rid of it. So let's just go ahead and get rid of these here. And you're going to see we have all kinds of different fun tools that we can add to our FaceTime call. I'm actually going to turn this around here. And now we're looking at the front-facing camera. When you're looking at the front-facing camera or the back camera, you can also set if it's in portrait mode or not. So a lot of different options with our camera. The last thing here that we have is this little circle. What is this? This allows me to take a screenshot. So if I wanted to take a screenshot of my FaceTime call, I tap on that and it'll save it to my Photos app. So that's how we can take a screenshot as well. I'm going to end this. Let's take a closer look at links. Links work basically the same way, but instead of making a call, what it does is it creates a link. So when I go over to create link here, it's not going to make a call. What it's going to do is it's going to create a link, and then from there, what I'm able to do is send it to other people. So I could message it to them, I could email them. When they click on that link, and if they're using Chrome or Brave or Edge, what they're going to be able to do is join your call. They don't have to have an Apple device. So that's what a link is. It's just another FaceTime call, but it's created through a link, and it allows people outside of the Apple ecosystem to join your meeting, join your FaceTime call. So that's how we can create links. You're also going to see here that we have our history. So I can scroll up and down to view the history. And if I want to remove any one of them, I just swipe over to the left and I can remove that. It'll delete that call. So that will no longer be in my history. So that is basically how FaceTime works on the iPhone. It's pretty straightforward for the most part. Basically, all we have to do is open up the FaceTime app. We set our profile. You do this once. And then from there, you decide if you want to make an audio call or if you want to make a FaceTime call with video. And if you want to call someone that is not on an Apple device, you can create a link and then have them join the FaceTime call through that link. When you are on a FaceTime call, what you're able to do is switch the camera. You can share your screen with someone else. They can share your screen with you. You can mute it. You can change the audio. You can even add effects when you're using video. When you are done, you just tap on the red X, and then your call will be ended. So that's how we make FaceTime calls on the iPhone.